Hello children, how are you all? Welcome to Ablon Public School at home. Children, in last class, I told you about mountains, types of mountains, and why mountains important for us. So, in today's class, we are going to learn about plateaus and plains. Before starting this, let's learn some good habits. So, here is a picture of a boy who is going to school. Children, we all should go to school on time. And if we are going school timely, then we reach very timely there and we can attend morning assembly also. In assembly, we get many informations related to schools and many general knowledge questions, informations, and we can worship to God also. It is very important part of our school. So children, we all should go to school on time. Now let's come on our topic. So let's know about plateaus. So a plateau is an elevated flat land. As you can see in the picture, there is a flat land. It is a flat topped table land standing above the surrounding area. Here is the next picture. A plateau may have one or more sides with steep slopes. Its slope is steep like this. Okay, children. The height of plateaus often varies from few hundred meters to several thousand meters. Means plateaus are also very huge. So plateaus like mountains may be young or old. The Deccan Plateau in India is one of the oldest plateaus. And the East African Plateau in Kenya, Tanzania and Uganda, and the Western Plateau of Australia are other examples. The Tibet Plateau is the highest plateau in the world with a height of 4000 to 6000 meters above the mean sea level. Okay, children. So this is very important fact that the Deccan Plateau is in India is one of the oldest plateau. Second most important part is the Tibet Plateau is the highest plateau in the world with a height of 4000 to 6000 meter above the mean sea level. So children, plateaus are very useful because they are rich in mineral deposits. Means inside of the plateaus there are minerals. As a result, many of the mining areas in the world are located in the plateau areas. African Plateau is famous for gold and diamond mining. In India, huge reserves of iron, coal and manganese are found in the Chota Nagpur Plateau. So in the plateau areas, there may be several waterfalls as the river falls from a great height. In India, the Hundru Falls in the Chota Nagpur Plateau on the river Subarnarekha and the Jog Falls in Karnataka are examples of such waterfalls. The lava plateaus are rich in black soil and that are very fertile and good for cultivation. Many plateaus have scenic spots also and are of great attraction to tourists. So plateaus are very important and useful for us. Next, we'll learn about plains. So plains are large stretches of flat land. They are generally not more than 200 meters above mean sea level. And some plains are extremely leveled. Others may be slightly rolling and undulating. Most of the plains are formed by rivers and their tributaries. The rivers flow down the slopes of mountains and erode them. They carry forward the eroded material. Then they deposit their loads consisting of stones, sand and silt along their courses and in their valleys. So So it is formed, these deposits, that plains are formed. Generally, plains are very fertile. So construction of transport network is very easy there. Thus, these plains are very thickly populated regions of the world. The most populated regions of the world are plain. Some of the largest plains made by the rivers are found in Asia and North America. For example, in Asia, these plains are formed by the Ganga and the Brahmaputra in India and the Yangtze in China. And you know, children, plains are the most useful areas for human habitation. There is a great concentration of people as more flat land is available for building houses as well as for cultivation. Because of fertile soils, the land is highly productive for cultivation. In India too, the Indo-Gangetic plains are the most densely populated regions of the country. So, I told you about plains and plateaus. Now children, revise. So what are plateaus? A plateau is an elevated flat land. It is flat topped table land standing above the surrounding area. And a plateau have one or more sides with steep slopes. And what are plains? Plains are large stretches of flat land and they are generally not more than 200 meters above mean sea level. And plains are very fertile. Now children, revise this concept and complete question answers related to this concept. Next, we will meet soon in the next part of this chapter. Till then, be good, take care of yourself and your family, and study well. Thank you. Have a great day.